Stand by for action.
Thanks for joining me. My name is Dave Milner. I am the Unpleasant Blind Guy, and I want to welcome you to part one of this episode of the Unpleasant Blind Guy on EDL Radio. Now remember, if you want to contact me with comments, questions, show suggestions, Awesome American suggestions, I'm available at UBG Contact on Twitter, or I can also be found as Dave Milner or Agador, that's A-G-G-E-D-O-R, on Mublet, the Tea Party Community, Spreely, Minds, MeWe, or Gab. Now let's begin.
News. News gives me the creeps.
Never in the field of human conflict was so much owed by so many to so few. I hope, indeed I pray, that we shall not be found unworthy of our victory if after toil and tribulation it is granted to us. For the rest, we have to gain the victory. That is our task.
Let us therefore brace ourselves to our duties, and so bear ourselves that if the British Empire and its commonwealths last for 1,000 years, men will still say, this was their finest hour.
We shall not fail or falter. We shall not weaken or tire. Neither the sudden shock of battle nor the long-drawn trials of vigilance and exertion will wear us down. Give us the tools, and we will finish the job.
We shall go on to the end. We shall fight with growing confidence and growing strength. We shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender.
Let me taste coffin.
Make me feel good.
Muslim.
I ain't afraid of no
Muslim.
Don't get caught alone, no, no.
ADL.
When it comes through your door, unless you're just a walk mode, I think you better call.
ADL.
Who you gonna call?
ADL.
Who you gonna call?
ADL.
I think you better call.
ADL.
Who you gonna call?
ADL.
I can't hear you. Who you gonna call?
ADL.
Louder.
ADL.
Who you gonna call?
ADL.
Who can you call?
ADL.
Who you gonna call?
ADL. Well, good evening and welcome to the English Defence League radio show, Halloween Funtacular 2019. Oh, well, that my wingman has surprised me with the opening this evening, ladies and gentlemen. But anyway, before we get onto the show, we've got a lot of great stuff, and happy Halloween to everybody out there. Welcome to the English Defence League radio show with your host, Jeff Spider Mitchell, and my wingman for this evening is Dave Space Monster Milner. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we are having a break for Halloween, a few decorations, maybe some music, and definitely some treats. Soldiers in the war for civilization need to relax now and again. And we are doing that for this show. Rest assured, our great listeners, that we never forget the real monsters prowling out there. The death cult of Islam and their toadies in government. And the fake stream media to their evil, we say, no surrender ever. All that is necessary for evil to prevail is that good men do nothing. That was by the late, great Edmund Burke. Those who make peaceful revolution impossible will make violent revolution inevitable. And that was by the late, great President John F. Kennedy. And without further ado, let me bring my wingman, my friend, my colleague, into the studio. Good evening, Dave. Wow, man, that was absolutely awesome. Thank you for the slides this evening and also for the great script for this evening. Dave surpassed things that I expected for this show. Dave, over to you, brother, and happy Halloween, brother.
And a happy Halloween to you, Jeff, and a happy Halloween to everybody in the UK, and a happy Halloween to everyone around the world, and of course, off Earth, where it can get really spooky. Yeah, well, Jeff, you know what, to quote the Underground Professor, hey, while everybody else is playing Monster Mash, I thought I'd do something a little bit different for this evening. Hope you enjoyed it.
Brilliant.
I didn't know whether you'd love it or you'd hate it.
I know this, Dave. You spent a lot of time cut and editing that. That was absolutely, I was rolling. I had to mute myself. I was laughing so much. Dave, thank you for that, brother.
That was fun. It was fun to do, Jeff. It was a lot of fun to do, yeah. You know, I mean, you got to have a little bit of fun for Halloween, and that's something that we want to get into. You know, I have a lot of Christian friends who say, I don't celebrate Halloween because that's a celebration for the night of the devil. Well, okay, let me just put it this way. This is my perspective, and Jeff, you can give yours afterwards, obviously, but okay, to me, here's the deal. Satan is a punk, okay? Now, he's always out there working his evil. Yeah, we see this in politics today. And everywhere like that, he's always out there working his evil. But in the end, when you stand up to him and you laugh at him and you make fun of him, he just shrivels away. That's how I see him. I see Satan as a very real danger, but I also see him as a punk. Okay? And so in that vein, I don't mind there being a day when, you know, the kids can get dressed up in little costumes and go around various places and beg for candy. It's fun. And we can put it in perspective because we can fight Satan's evil all year round and we can have a little bit of fun and laugh at him and say, hey, man, you know, you're not only a punk, you're the biggest loser ever in history because in the end, you are going to lose. So, yeah, I say happy Halloween to all and a happy Halloween to you, Jeff. What do you think, brother?
Well said, Dave. Yeah, I mean, we have Satan all year round mocking good people in the world. Today, we, the EDL, which I really love what you're doing there, Dave, we're mocking Satan. Yeah, we mock him because that is what we do. You know, he mocks us all year round. And, yeah, type a bit of payback now and again, isn't it, Anna? I think that's what we do when we do these shows, Dave. Especially the Halloween show this evening. So, as you called him a punk, I just, you know, I just mock him. I just mock that thing. Let's not call it him. It's a him. Whatever. It's just pure evil. But we can mock. We can laugh and dance. We can dance with the devil and we can get him in a wrestle hold and we can bind him down. Can't we, Dave? You know? And that's what we do.
He
will definitely, the kingdom, what he thinks this is will fall by the wayside, and not too distant future. Of course, he's going to put a big battle up. We do know what happens in the end times, and it's going to be pretty brutal. We know that. But are we prepared? I think we are. Most of us who've had our eyes open, you know, we are prepared for whatever the outcome, because we know in the end that peace will reign and goodness of mankind will live on.
That it will.
That is prevalent. That is why I tend to look at things. I'm an optimist. No matter how dark the news sometimes we hear and we come across, I do believe in we will overcome whatever is put before us, because that is our path. That is what we shall do. We shall over... No, sorry, Dad, didn't want to break in. I thought you said we'd have some fun tonight, didn't you?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
fun till the daddy brings a tea bird. Dave, I'm on my mic.
Very nice, Jeff. Well, you know, we also want to say, since this is Halloween, okay, black cats, all right. People now over here in the, you know, they're in the UK, you know, you guys are in full Halloween swing and we're just about to get into it here in the United States. People are just about to get off work and whatnot and everything. And, you know, the kids are, well, they're probably going out now. Certainly they are up here in the northern parts of the States, and they'll be doing the similar in the southern parts as the show goes on and as the evening goes on. And one of the things we wanted to remind people of this year is, okay, black cats are not magical. They're not evil. There's nothing supernatural about. They're just cats. They're just cats with black fur. That's all they are. Okay. So don't hurt them for Halloween. Don't have any dumb, stupid ritual that you don't know any damn thing about, just to give you an excuse to hurt a cat. And you know, look. If a black cat
don't forget,
crosses your
they're
path,
all God's creatures, cats,
they are,
dogs,
yes, they are.
All animals are God's creatures. Always bear that in mind, and don't forget, animals are what look to us. Don't forget, when they look towards us, they look of unconditional love. So please don't disrespect the animals. And I know we are animal loving people, but we know there are certain people out there. that we often talk about who just care nothing about animals. They don't care about fellow human beings. They definitely mm-hmm. don't care about the animals, because you see the way how brutal that they do treat these animals, and it is heartbreaking. But unfortunately, evil does live in the world, and they are the people that do them things are pure evil. How anybody can hurt an innocent animal, I don't know. I really don't understand the logic, the mentality of these people. But there you go. I know a lot of you listening to the show this evening are good-hearted people, and animal lovers like myself, like Dave. Dave loves cats. He's always sending me videos of cats. He loves them. That and parrots. Dave loves cats and parrots, don't you, Dave?
Well, Charlie is our executive producer here, so yeah, naturally, Jeff. Yeah, naturally. But the thing also, guys, is if you see a black cat crossing your path, now it's a little bit different in the States than it is in the UK. In the States, it's considered bad luck if a black cat crosses your path. In the UK and other places, it's considered good luck. But really, all that's happening is the cat's going somewhere. Leave it alone, okay? Just leave it alone and have a good and fun and safe Halloween. And definitely, and I know, Jeff, you will agree with this, that definitely, guys, you know, you're out there, you've got your kids going out trick-or-treating and everything. Just make sure they're safe, okay? You know, because as we report throughout the year, there are just too many people out there ready to victimize kids. So, yeah, just be safe. As Jeff says, be vigilant. Am I right on that, Jeff?
Yeah, no, that's right, Dave. Sadly, I mean, in the UK, we do live these days, parents really are concerned with their children. As most people that listen to this show know, that we have issues with predators out there. If children are out any sort of a time, they could be in danger. It depends the areas you live, but as I say, I've looked around this evening, Dave, and it's really quiet where I live. It's a few years ago, you used to all see. I mean, my next door neighbours, they do the whole thing. They dress up for it, you know. You would see outside. They just love it, you know. It's just what they like doing, but. Unfortunately, we do live in that time where the parents and the children, they don't, you know, the children to be out there, especially in the UK at this moment in time, unless they're with the parents. And as I say, sadly, I've looked around this evening, it's just seemed so quiet around me. But one day, that sort of thing might, you know, get back some sort of normality where parents can go with the kids and, you know, and have a bit of fun, knock on a few people's doors, you know, trick and treat. You know, it's where it used to be. I remember years ago, I mean, my kids always used to go out trick and treating, and then I used to get the complaints the following day for some people up there. They didn't like the egg that was thrown, they didn't like the treat. You know?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Your boy threw an egg at me. Well, what did you do? I told him to bugger off. Well, that's why he threw an egg at you. What do you think? It was trick or treat, wasn't it?
Yeah, you don't give out the treats, you get the tricks. That's it, man.
Yeah. Watch the egg go splat.
That's the way it works. Yeah, that's the way it works. Well, we've got a thing over here, Jeff. It's called, and I'm sure you guys have seen it in the UK. It's called It's a Great Pumpkin, Charlie Brown. And when they go out trick-or-treating, Charlie Brown just gets a bag full of rocks. But they don't give him candy. They just give him a rock. And every time I see that thing, because I've got it on DVD, I make sure to play it on my Halloween. You know, I always say to the TV, yeah, if it were me getting a bag full of rocks, I know where those rocks would be going. You know, but that's just me. They're going to give me candy. They're going to give everybody else candy. Give me a rock here. Have it back. Yeah.
A bit of fun.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
yeah,
I'm sneezing. I've got the sneezing.
Bless you, man.
They normally say, when you keep sneezing, it's something to do with ghost spirit being around you. So I've got a couple of spirits around me.
Well, you better be careful, Jeff. You know, from what you tell me, your mom might, clout you one across the ear hole.
The spiritual slap around the ear. Oh, dear, that made me jump.
Yeah, it would. I have a feeling, Jeff, I have to ask this, okay? It's a bit personal, and you don't have to answer if you don't want to on there. I have a feeling your mom kind of, at least tolerated Halloween if she didn't enjoy it. How was she on Halloween?
She's flying around the broomstick. No, she didn't. No, sorry, Mum.
Careful, man. Careful.
No, to be honest with you, I mean, you're going back many years. I'm not sure how we celebrated it back then. It was a long time ago. When I was, say, 15 or something, you're talking, oh, my goodness, mate, I don't know, though, if we really did celebrate. I'm sure we did in some ways, but I just can't reflect back to that time, with my mum, what she felt about it or anything like that. I mean, I'd say my mum and my nan, I mean, I come from a church-going background. I mean, my nan
right,
was very, very religious. My mum wasn't. I mean, my mum wasn't as like my nan, but we still, when I was growing up, I had to go to Bible classes in the morning, and then my parents and I would have to go along for the church, the church service. So it was... We used to have to be dressed up. Sundays, if you look on sort of, prairie, that's what we used to have to dress up. It was a special day, wasn't it?
And don't mess up that suit of clothes, man. Don't mess up that suit of clothes.
That's your best clothes. Don't you bloody get them trousers. That's what my mum used to tell me.
Yeah.
And you always wanted to be out there with your mates, didn't you? But... this is just traditional. All families at that time, people did go to church quite a lot, But, that's the way it was. But I can't remember too much about Halloween back when I was when I was growing up. I do know that it's always been a height of events in the United States. I always remember that. But over here, it was just coming to light, if you know what I'm saying. In early times back in when horses still pull carts about, Dave, when I was young.
Well, I was about
we
to ask
the
you didn't paint that
guy down the road in his cart, lumber, and that was people to come out and bring out their bits and pieces, and he'd give you a bit of money for your tuk, what it used to call tuk back in the time. But that was a long time ago now, mate. It was a long time ago. And back in the day, horses used to pull the milk floats about. Yeah, back in the early 50s, Dave.
But, I have a feeling she would have enjoyed the day. Just enjoyed the kids having fun just as long as it didn't bring trouble back to the house there. But anyway, Jeff.
I should do enough of that without being Halloween at the time.
Yeah. Oh, exactly.
Someone knocking on my door complained about me. He trampled all over my daffodils. I said he trampled all over. You didn't have to tell me twice. I heard you the first time. Don't worry. Get out of here. Wouldn't you be trampled? No, it didn't work. Yes, it was. I know it was you. I see the back of your shoes.
There you go. Well, yeah.
Dave, I was always up to mischief.
Well, in a way,
that's a bit of fun, though. Nothing serious. Knocked down Ginger. Poor old Ginger.
Right.
Everybody kept knocking him down all the time. When I say that, Dave, you might think, knocked down Ginger? What did Ginger ever do? No, it was a name used to call for knocking on people's doors and then running away.
Oh, just, okay, okay. Yeah.
Our American friends know. It's not, no, knocking down poor old Ginger. No, it was what we used to call it. Back then. Yeah.
We did the same thing, Jeff, over here.
Adventurous, Dave. We used to tie a bit of string to the door handles, about three or four doors along, and then we used to knock one door and pull the string, and people would be coming to the door saying, what the hell's looking for us?
Nice.
Everyone's hiding laughing.
Nice. Now, that's one we never did, that I can think of. You know, that's one we never did over here. Now, if people wanted to get really nasty, and this wasn't necessarily something they did for Halloween, I mean, aside just from you know, literally smashing pumpkins. I'm not talking about the band. I'm talking about, like, you know, just smashing somebody's Halloween pumpkin that they'd have out, you know, their jack-o'-lantern.
That's pretty brutal, Dave. That's pretty brutal. Yeah.
that's not as brutal as what I'm going to talk about. You know, what some kids would do, and I never did this. Thank you. But
no.
You know, what some kids would do would be they'd take a paper sack, all right, and they would fill it, you know, part of the way full of manure. Put it on the doorstep, and set it on fire, and then knock on the door and run away. So when they came out, they you know, I mean, 9 times out of 10, when someone came out, they'd try and, like, you know, stomp the fire out, and guess what would come out? It's pretty nasty, man.
I wonder who thought that up. Dave, you're laughing too much there, but you just need to do this, Dave.
Hey, I never did, man. I never did. But I left when people came. You know, so.
But you knew all about it.
Of course, yeah. I had the knowledge.
I know.
I had the knowledge. Yeah, man.
Don't let you get all your secrets out, Dave, because it knocks on your door.
Oh, no, I never tell anybody.
All these years, Dave.
Oh, yeah, I never tell anybody everything I know. But, no, you know, it's an interesting holiday. And for the most part, nowadays, though, like I said, it's just kids going from door to door begging for candy, you know, and adults having you know, like parties and stuff like that, not interesting costumes and stuff like that. You name a superhero, and kids are
oh, really?
Up as that.
It's all about fancy dress, isn't it, Dave? If you look at, like,
well, that's what
you
guys are called.
More of a creepy aspect to it, but really, truthfully, it's just about fancy dress. Bit different, yeah. It's good.
Oh, yeah,
people like to do it. Kids like to do it. It's just what they like doing, dressing up and doing things like that, dressing up in skeleton gear and Dracula and those sort of things. It gives them, gives them something to occupy their minds, doesn't it? Good luck to the kids. And the adults.
Oh, yeah.
You know, adults enjoy it. I know my next door neighbours do. They really do. So, good on.
Well, I hope the kids are out there having fun and being safe. You know, one of the best costumes I have to say I ever saw in my entire life was...
And that is it for this time. Next time, part 2. I appreciate each and every one of you. Thank you for listening, and may your God go with you. Goodbye.
The Unpleasant Blind Guy is copyright 2019. Anno Domini. Now for Dave's Canes, extras that help you navigate the new media world.
Conservative media done right. You're listening to the SHR Media Network.
Hey, this is Michael Wright.
And I'm Shannon Wright.
Join us for The Right Way with Shannon and Mike, Monday through Thursday from 7 to 9 a.m. right here on SHR Media.
Why are they joining us?
For fun things like sports, politics.
Oh, maybe some news and entertainment?
And all kinds of other things.
Money and recipes and events, all kinds of stuff.
Yeah, so join us Monday through Thursday, 7 to 9 a.m. here on shrmedia.com.
From a public locker inside a dilapidated Long Island rail station comes a show designed to piss off liberals using truth, facts, and ridicule. The Lid Radio Show, featuring the conservative voice from the People's Republic of New York. The Lid himself, Jeff Dunnitz. Tune in every Wednesday at 2 p.m. Eastern, 11 a.m. Pacific on the SHR Media Network. Go to shrmedia.com. At Lid Radio, we fight for the truth, justice, and a good kosher T-bone. If you don't listen, Hillary Clinton might sneak into your bedroom in her house coat late at night and blame you for her election loss. It's the Lid Radio Show with Jeff Dunnitz.
It's your business diva here, Melanie Collette. I am inviting you to a front row seat as I discuss some of the most intriguing details of wealth and finance with today's movers and shakers in the world of business. Listen in and discover financial truths on a global, domestic, and household scale. Uncover topics that will impact your wallet today and in the future. Money Talk with Melanie airs Monday through Friday, 5 p.m. East, 2 p.m. West, right here on SHR Media and High Plains Pundit Talk Radio. You can't afford to miss it.
The new show on the SHR Media Network, Sackheads Against Tyranny, on shrmedia.com. Go there quick like a bunny, 11 p.m. Eastern, 8 p.m. Pacific, every Wednesday, live and direct on the SHR Media Network, shrmedia.com. Be there.
Broadcasting behind enemy lines in occupied California, a mere 2 miles from the state capital, the Bloviating Zeppelin's Berserk Bobcat Saloon Radio Show can be heard every Tuesday and Thursday night at 8 p.m. Pacific and 11 p.m. Eastern, only on the SHR Media Network. Go to shrmedia.com to listen. You can also watch on the SHR Media Facebook page and the SHR Media YouTube channel. No goldfish were abused in the making of this ad.
Hey girls, Carry Girl Gear is here. More and more women every day are concealed carrying, participating in competitive shooting, and getting firearms training. It's not a boys' club anymore, and we don't have to shop in their stores anymore either. Finally, a cool and unique clothing line just for women. Dope tees and hats for the patriotic concealed carry and 2A girl. So what are you waiting for? Go check out carrygirlgear.com today.
Conservative media done right. You're listening to the SHR Media Network.